My boy, my boy, my boy, don't love me like you promised. My boy, my boy, my boy, he ain't a man and sure as hell ain't honest. My
basically, today I am going to London, to Wembley Arena, to watch the React War Turkey card with Chris Conger and Dale Riley on the card. I'm just going to get the coach now and I'm going to see how good it's going to be. I went to Wembley Stadium to watch Fury White. This is going to be a lot more chill because there's less douchebags and it's not as huge of a card, so we'll see how it goes.
My boy's being sus, and he don't know how to cuss. He just sounds like he's trying to be his father. My boy's an ugly crier, but he's such a pretty liar.
Right, I'm in the hotel room now. I've got a couple hours before the fight, so I'm gonna get some shut-eye, and then we'll get going to the underground and get going to Wembley, boy. Here at Wembley Park, stadium's in front of me. I'm on the way to the arena. Really looking forward to it. So we've got Turchi versus React War, Chris Congo versus someone, I forgot his opponent, and Bedell Riley. Really looking forward to watching those fights. It's not as big of a card as the Tyson Fury one, obviously, so it's a lot quieter around here. You can relax a little bit, and I feel like it'd be a lot easier getting. Probably have a better time as well. So yeah, it's time to go, boy. I'm going to be fighting in all these places one day, making mad amount of money. There's the arena over there, and here's the great stadium. Mate, I remember how packed this was for Tyson Fury. It was ridiculous. Like, sardines, mate.
Welcome to the Oval Arena White here in Wembley. Brought to you by Ben Shalom on Sky Sports, Facebook, and YouTube. Begins in the super flyweight division. First, to make her way into the arena, please welcome Gemma Bruin.
Yeah.
Judges seem to pass the same way in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and your new WBC International Global Welterweight Champion, Chris. Stone 1 pound. This man stands undefeated at 5 victories, fighting out of Hackney, London, introducing Vital Riley!
Break is breaking, and protect yourselves in our time. Touch of gloves, here we go. Good luck, guys.
Yakuza!
Sanctioned by the International Boxing Federation, with supervisors Tony Tibetti, judges Vincent Dupas, Marcus McDonald, and Enrico Pierlizzi. Midnight Train, Richard Riakpo.
Midnight Train's coming.
All of the time, he's here to be me, always be mine, always be mine. I'll be the
month.
You better sit back down to me. Sit back down to me. Say that you're coming for me. Sit back down to me. Sit back down to me. Sit back down to me.
White. And standing 6'5" tall and weighing officially 14 stone and 4 pounds. As a professional, he is undefeated with 14 career victories, 10 by way of knockout, fighting out of Woolworth, London, introducing the Midnight Train, Richard! Steve Gray.
Second shot.
Yeah, when you're ready to go, you're just gonna charge in there, mate.
Steve Gray accepted the retirement of the blue corner in favor of your winner of the IBF World Cruiserweight Title Eliminator, the undefeated Midnight Train, Richard
Right, so that's the end of a really fucking good night. Met some good people. I met a couple of guys, Paul and his son, Lucas, and they're legends. Had a great night sat with them, having a laugh, having a joke, talking about fights, getting into it. It's a really good night for me, and I appreciate it a lot. Richard React for that crazy knockout, though. I swear I heard the guy's rib snap from where I was. But yeah, it's just been a hell of an experience. I also got to meet Chris Congo. I had a conversation with him. I told him how good he was, and I didn't bug him for a photo because obviously that's disrespectful, and I didn't want to like be trying to get something from him. I just wanted to tell him how good he did and that he did a really good performance against a high level of competitor. So it was an honor to meet him, shake his hand, tell him how good he did, and yeah, moving on. I'm looking forward to like the next fights. Riakpor against any titleist. Akoli would be a brilliant one, but literally anyone would be fucking awesome. Chris Congo going up levels. If he beats Sebastian Formella in a, which is a very high level test for any welterweight. It's one of the guys who is a gatekeeper. Has beaten some of the best, not beaten some of the best, but gone the distance with some of the best, like Sean Porter, etc., etc. So that's, I'm looking forward to his future. Vidal Riley with a fucking beautiful footwork to land that left hook. Fucking awesome first round knockout. I managed to get it all on camera, which was awesome. What else? Here we go. Two women's fights that I was actually really interested in. I didn't know they'd be on the card, but I was interested in them. There's the fight, Rueg versus, I'm forgetting their names, Shannon Ryan. Shannon Ryan looks slick. I respect Gemma Rueg. I always root for her because obviously she's from near me, and also she follows me on Instagram, so it's sort of like a cool thing. But really slick performance from her. And then the next fight, again, forget the name of the woman, she fucking hits like a truck and had this awesome brawler style where she's just rolling all in your face, head in your chest, hitting you with three or four shots, moving out. It was really good to watch. So they were good, and they were at the beginning of the card. Every single fight on this card was really good. Zach Chelly with a great win. All of it. It was. Oh, and the first round knockout where I've already forgot the acronym. But with his brother next to me, screaming his head off. It was just an awesome night. So appreciate you guys watching. Take it easy.
Guns on the left, racks to death. Blitz on the right, wild for the night. Pumps in the back, come on in the crack to one hand in the...